Ladies and gentlemen, the 2014 Boys Rolex Player of the Year from Shreveport, Louisiana, Mr. Sam Burns.
This looks a little bit different than practice this morning. First off, I'd like to thank my Savior Jesus Christ for all the opportunities this year and all the blessings that I've had. To the AJGA, Stephen Hamlin, thank you for everything that you've done for me personally and for everyone sitting in this room. The staff for all their hard work. I know y'all put in endless hours to make all this happen. Mr. Nicholson with Rolex, thank you for your generous sponsorship. Ralph Lauren, Mr. Bill Huntington, Rolex stuff, pretty sweet. To Titleist, Mr. Jim Ahern, Nick Gillum, FootJoy, thank you for all the support over the years. Probably hard to deal with, but thank you. My family and friends for the support. Cannot be here without y'all. Mom, Dad, you mean the world to me. Brother and sister, sister-in-law, who are always there to support me, whether I finish last or first. My coach, Brad Pullen, who cannot be here, but thank you. Despite what it may sound like from the introduction just given, this year has not been all trophies and glamour. There have been some significant bumps in the road. The times in your life when you face adversity are the times when you find out who you truly are. Those are the times when you learn how much motivation and passion you really have, because anyone can keep going when the going is easy. It is when things get hard or discouraging that people tend to give up. There's a famous quote by Marcus A. Custer, which I'm sure many of you are familiar with, that says, it's not how many times you get knocked down, but it's how many times you get back up. At the beginning of this year, I finished 48th out of 54 players in the Junior Invitational at Sage Valley. It was one of the worst feelings I've ever had, and a low point in my golf career so far. It felt like I'd hit rock bottom, and leading up to that week, I just wasn't committed to myself or my practice routine. But when I got home, I believe God taught me a lesson of humility that week that I'll never forget. He opened my eyes and made me realize how fortunate and blessed all of us are just to be able to play the game that we all love. One of my best friends, Philip Barbary, showed me a Bible verse after I got home that's since become my favorite. It says, humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. 1 Peter 5, 6, and 7. There are so many kids our age dealing with problems that are much greater than bogeys, such as cancer and other disabilities. My close friend Nathan Johnson, who I've been friends with for almost a decade, has type 1 diabetes. He was diagnosed at a young age. An insulin pump is attached to him every day, giving him various amounts of insulin as he sees fit. Even with the most careful calculation, his blood sugars still vary at times on the golf course, causing him to be tired and lightheaded at times, and even have vision problems. He could sit around and complain and wonder, why me? Why do I have to have this? But instead, he wakes up every day and faces his challenge head on. He betters himself not only in golf every day, but in life. He's an inspiration to me. I can remember sitting in the same seats you are sitting in just one short year ago, watching Scotty and Allison give their speeches. I told myself that night that if, only if, I would commit myself to the process and take no shortcuts, I would be up here the next year. I challenge you all tonight to commit to your goals and let nothing stop you. My friend Nathan doesn't. There will be people that try to bring you down and obstacles that distract you from obtaining your dreams. But if you keep your eyes focused on God and go down the path he has for each of you, then the only thing that can keep you from achieving your dreams is you. God bless.
Don't forget your word, buddy. Good job up there. Very well done.